How to get lots of colour into your portraits, part 2. Take the photograph of your subject and square it off. Then take your watercolour paper and square that off to produce whatever scale you require. Let's get some tones into our picture now. So with black acrylic, paint first of all the darkest darks, and then two intermediate tones of grey should be sufficient. Next, take some blue acrylic. Examine your photograph for the areas that appear to be most blue and carefully add about three different tones of blue, starting with the very darkest blue. We now undertake a similar process but using red acrylic. Again, about three tones of red should be sufficient. The last colour that we will now apply is yellow. Again, three tones will be enough. Try not to overdo it. We don't want a jaundiced look. We now apply pastels to the dried acrylic paint. Layer upon layer. After each layer, we spray the pastels with a pastel fixing spray. The pastel fixing spray will push the pastel grains down into the indentations of the watercolour paper and allow the underpainting to show through. So the spray will control how much underpainting shows through. Next, scrub some acrylic colours into the background. Try and use complementary colours. Notice how we've used blue as a complementary colour to the orange of his hair, and green to complement the red of his football shirt. Add some pastels now to the background acrylic. Choose different colours and again use the fixing spray method to control how much of the background painting shows through the pastels. Take a look now at some of the details of the painting. Notice the quantity and the richness of the colours that this technique allows you to achieve.